The Canola School on RealAgriculture.com is brought to you by BASF Canada and Invigor Hybrid Canola.
Kara Oosterhuis here with RealAgriculture.com. I am back here today with a Canola School episode, and I have here with me Allison McLellan, who is a technical service specialist with BASF. How is it going today?
It's great.
We're out in the field, so that's always good news, and we're getting to that time of the year producers are starting to dig around. Now, lots of the prairies, it's been dry. If you're out and you're kind of looking around and you're going to seed some canola this year, what sorts of suggestions do you have for producers?
Yeah, so it is fairly dry. We're standing in southern Alberta right now. So as you can see, our conditions back here are quite dry this time of the year. There's usually still water laying around, and there's definitely not that here. So you can see that this grower has done a little bit of light tillage. He's definitely harrowed this field specifically. So that might be a recommendation for the guys that are going into drier soil. You definitely wouldn't want to do anything heavier than that. That minimum tillage is sometimes a great idea when you have a little bit more moisture. But in this area, their harrowing is maybe a great idea, or even direct seeding. So the other thing that you might want to look at is your seeding depth. So right now we still have fairly good moisture here. You may want to still target that 3/4 of an inch for your depth, but you can go a little bit deeper. So we've been finding with our agronomic excellence research that you can actually seed a little bit deeper. So always keep in mind the different things that you have going on in your farm. So whether you have different topographies, whether you have hills that may be a little bit drier or some low spots, that may also impact your drill type. So how accurately you can set your drill for depth might be one thing to consider when you are going a little bit deeper as well. You don't want to have that seed stranded in your soil. It's more prone to disease if it's down there for a little bit longer as well. So always some extra things to keep in mind when seeding into dry soil.
Now, is there any certain amount of depth? Like you said, you don't want that seed stranded in there. Is there a hard, fast rule for how deep to seed?
Definitely not. I would say that that's one of the common errors that we make when seeding canola is we always want to target that 3/4 of an inch. And I'm finding now that if we're on these lighter soils, maybe we are a little bit safer going a little bit deeper. So if you do have moisture at 3/4 of an inch, that's great. That's perfect. You can still stick with that. But if we don't have moisture there, we might want to go a little bit deeper. So maybe down to an inch, maybe down to 1.25 inches, but I wouldn't go any further past that.
Now, what other considerations are you going to want to keep in mind when it comes to seeding into drier areas like this? When it comes to, you know, herbicide carryover, stuff like that, is that going to be of mind?
Yeah, herbicide carry is something that you always want to keep in mind. So what your past rotation is, what you've sprayed in the past, that's something that when you go in to spray to clean up your weeds in this time of year with your pre-seed application, you might want to be cautious of what you put down. Another thing that you might want to watch is your fertilizer placement. So with your drier soils, you might have a little bit more fertilizer burn if you have a little bit too much in your seed row. So really watch those rates when you're putting that into your seed row.
Okay, awesome. Is there anything else you'd like to add?
No, I think we're good.
Okay, awesome. Thanks.